Now, signal number 5 raced over the northern and eastern portions of Batanes due to Super Typhoon Leon. The storm is packing winds of 195 kilometers per hour near the center and gusts of up to 240 kilometers per hour. It was last spotted some 100 kilometers east-northeast of Itbayat, Batanes. PAGASA warns of a high risk of life-threatening storm surge within the next 48 hours over the exposed coastal localities of Batanes and Babuyan Islands. But the Weather Bureau says a landfall scenario is now becoming less likely. Leon has already reached peak intensity and is expected to weaken into a typhoon over the next 12 hours before slamming into Taiwan. Super Typhoon Leon is now at its peak as it makes its closest approach to Batanes. Jack Batalyones gives us a look at how the northernmost Luzon provinces prepared for the monster storm.
In the first week of October, Super Typhoon Julian battered the province of Batanes. The province has yet to recover from the damage caused by Julian. It is now being battered by Super Typhoon Leon. As early as Monday, communities worked together to remove potential hazards and clear the water passage under the old Spanish bridge in Barangay Tuhel. Temporary shelters are also stocked and ready to receive evacuees, as signal number 5 may be raised in the province. By noon, power plants were shut down throughout the province. Ilocos Norte is feeling the effects of Super Typhoon Leon, prompting a work cancellation Wednesday afternoon. Farmers fear that if heavy rains persist, their rice fields, already damaged by severe tropical storm Christine, will be destroyed. In Isabela, more than 100 people living near coastal areas in Divilacan were evacuated due to strong waves caused by Super Typhoon Leon. 8 villages were affected.
Ayun ang communication sa amin, walang internet kung minsan, papatay-patay, pati mga radio communication namin, mga base, nag-aalangan yun, malakas din ang kwan, ang hampas ng hangin na nagkakandibali yung mga kwan namin, mga antena.
In Ilagan, relief packs continue to be distributed not only for those affected by Christine, but residents who may be impacted by Super Typhoon Leon. So far, some 8,000 relief packs have been given out. Most of the aid recipients are from the isolated village of San Antonio.
Yung po yung minomonitor natin, dito po sa lungsod ng Ilagan, kung sakaling lalakas ang tubig ulan na bubuhos po dito sa ating lungsod. Sa kasulukuyan po ang ating mga overflow bridges, Bacolod at Santa Maria ay passable po naman po.
Meanwhile, President Bongbong Marcos emphasized the need to prepare for the possible effects of Super Typhoon Leon. The Manila International Airport Authority also reminded airline companies of their responsibility to passengers if flights are canceled.
We have a team actively monitoring itong typhoon. We are hoping our passengers can actively monitor and directly coordinate with their airlines para pagka merong mga cancellations, no, agad po silang ma-inform.
Passengers are reminded to arrive at the airport 3 hours before their flight for international flights and 2 hours for domestic flights. Jack Batalyones, ABS-CBN News.
Forced evacuations were carried out in the Philippine province of Batangas as Super Typhoon Leon passed by the eastern waters of the Luzon region. The new storm comes in the aftermath of severe tropical storm Christine, which cost billions of pesos of damages across the Philippines. Dennis Datu reports.
Local disaster officials in Balete in the province of Batangas are going door-to-door to warn residents of the approaching Super Typhoon Leon. Residents living near Taal Lake have been asked to evacuate amid rough waters and large waves triggered by Leon's strong winds.
Siyempre po, natatakot po. Eh, kaya nga po naghahanda uli kami para pagdabating po yung bagyo, eh, makalikas po kami agad.
The local government says they are not leaving anything to chance as they order forced evacuations to prevent the loss of lives. Balete was among the municipalities that experienced deadly landslides due to severe tropical storm Christine.
Ito ho ay nangyari na kay Christine, so ay nahuli natin maulit ang ganitong pangyayari. Ay na natin may mga buhay pa na mapisala dahil nga sa hindi pag katigasan din ng ulo ng ating mga ilang kababayan.
Forced evacuation ba?
Forced na po at hindi papayag po ang ating PNP ngayon.
Meantime, all 400 families living on the island of Sitio Chaten have been evacuated. 6 people are still missing in the area after Christine-induced floods swept away several homes. Search and retrieval operations have been suspended due to inclement weather. In the city of Lipa, over 260 families were asked to leave their homes, particularly residents of Sitio Tagbakin in Barangay Halang near Taal Lake. Road clearing operations are expected to be suspended once heavy rains begin. A portion of the cemetery in Agoncillo, Batangas has collapsed due to soil erosion affecting 14 graves. The cemetery management has begun making arrangements to relocate those buried in the affected plots, but this will not be completed before All Saints Day.
Basta sabi ko po sa kanila, ginagawa po namin ng paraan na mapaglipatan. Dahil wala mo naman po nagkagustan magkaganyan eh.
Latest reports from the National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council show 145 people have died nationwide due to the devastation caused by severe tropical storm Christine. 37 individuals are still missing. Damage to agriculture has reached 2.87 billion pesos, while damage to infrastructure stands at 3.6 billion pesos. A total of 206 towns and cities have declared a state of calamity. In the Bicol region, 55 deaths have been reported, according to the Office of Civil Defense Bicol. 471 villages across the entire Bicol region are inundated and 113 roads remain impassable by any type of vehicle. In Naga City, 4 villages remain inundated, but clearing operations have kicked off. Dennis Dato, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine Mayor Nelson Legacion denies his office intentionally underreported disaster relief aid distributed in his city by the foundation of his 2025 election rival, former Vice President Lenny Robredo. The Naga City Mayor clarifies the report on aid from the Angat Buhay Foundation was based solely on the statement of one village captain. The village chief supposedly mentioned that Robredo's group only gave 200 food packs for residents affected by Tropical Storm Christine. Robredo denounced the report as an irresponsible representation of her foundation's relief efforts. Angat Buhay says it had already given hot meals and relief supplies to over 102,000 calamity victims as of Tuesday evening. Mayor Legacion explains the report on his city's relief distribution was only supposed to cover donations coursed through his local government. Robredo is running against Legacion for Naga City Mayor next year.
There was no malice, there was no bad intention. It only happened that the figure was included in the report of the city, which was intended to respond to the call to be transparent, to be accountable. I was telling my team that the relief goods or assistance given by Angat Buhay, for instance, and any other organizations should not be included in the report of the city government of Naga, because we are not supposed to be accountable for that. It is true that the number does not really reflect the kind of assistance that Angat Buhay had been extending to the people of Naga.